built this working wooden aero engine 8 years ago, but I never made video of its construction. So I printed out some of the plans, and in this video, I'm actually going to build it again. And I actually printed these using my big print program so I could lighten the solid yellow areas so I wouldn't be wasting as much ink. Got all the main plywood pieces cut. In the plans, I have this dowel as a 5/8 inch dowel, but I don't actually have any kicking around, so I'm going to use a 1/2 inch dowel, and the important thing is to be able to drill a hole that it slides freely so it can slide through the holes on the end. I'm just going to mark every one of these from all four sides. Now in the plans, I have this layer screwed onto the piston housing, but I'm pretty confident this is going to work because I'm building it the second time around, so I'm just going to glue that on. You can also cut the parts out using a scroll saw, and that might be a little bit easier. The sides of the smaller slot are beveled for better airflow. The cavities in here form channels to bring the air to the middle, and then this is the valve, and it slides between these two pieces, and then there's a cover on here. Now I just need to glue those two pieces on here so that this part can slide. I'll put this spacer in here just to make sure I have a little bit of gap, and now let's glue this up. I need to take this apart and clean up the glue squeeze out before it's fully dried. Still doesn't slide as easily as I'd hoped. I'll just use the belt sander to add some retroactive precision. Now to make sure this part slides easily when this is screwed on here, I'm going to put a paper shim in here, and then this on here, and I'll sand this flush. And that way I can be sure I have just the right amount of gap in here for this to slide easily. In the plans, I have all these layers screwed together, but I already glued this part. And I think I'm also going to glue this part, partially because I'm lazy and also because I already know this is going to work. And with all this glue in here, I don't have to worry about how good the seal is going to be because the glue seals it off. Now I need to fit this piston thing in here, and that's going to be tricky because it needs to be very close to the sides, but it needs to slide freely. But before I start tweaking it, I'm going to mark which way I've got it in there so that I'll put it in the same way. Now this piston is a little bit loose on the dowel, so to get a bit more support for it, I made these two pieces to go on either side of it. And that's okay because the piston doesn't actually travel all the way to the end of the cylinder. For this crank in here, I need about 8 millimeters of off-center for that dowel in the middle. So I need to glue another piece of dowel against here with 8 millimeters of offset. And for that, I need to carve a little bit out like this. That took a bit of whittling, but now it fits on here like this. I'm just eyeballing the screw hole locations. Now I should have done this before I cut this apart, because now I have to clamp it back together while I drill it. I'm adding a little bit more retroactive precision before I glue the legs onto the cylinder. Now I have to carve away part of the original dowel so I can clamp this part onto this dowel. I've got the flywheel protruding into the base a little bit, so I need to cut a slot right here for that. When mounting these together, the cranks need to be offset by 90 degrees. So one crank is here, and then this crank needs to be 90 degrees offset so that the control valve is in the right phase. Now, in terms of alignment, it's very important that when this crank is in the middle, it comes out exactly in the middle between the slots here. So I need to move the piston right about here. I took the engine all apart for varnishing, and I put water-based varnish on everything, including some of the bearing surfaces. And that means I can put a drop of oil on there without having the oil soak all over the wood. I also varnished this rod here, and that took a bit of tweaking to get it to slide freely again. Ideally, there should not be enough room for a piece of paper to fit between the piston and the walls. It should get stuck. There was a few places where I could slide it in easily, so I just glued on a strip of paper to close some of that gap. And it also needs to slide very easily. So now if I completely block all the valve inlets with this piece of metal, the cylinder falls very slowly from air resistance. And here I'm actually using the air engine to pump air to power the other air engine. But as you can see, it's really not very efficient. These air engines aren't really suitable for powering anything. And one final thing, I realized I put the connecting rod on the wrong side of the flywheel. It needs to be on the same side as the holes that lighten it to compensate for the weight of the piston. And with this configuration, it shakes a lot less.